What are the differences that you see in restaurants in abroad as compared to the Indian market?
The biggest difference I'd say that in Indian restaurants, the menu is huge. We try to satisfy anyone and everyone that walks into the restaurant. Whereas if you go abroad, especially to the Western restaurants, the menu is very lean. You won't see 200 items in the menu, which is very, very common in Indian restaurants. So the quality of what they're serving out actually also is really good, because you only have to focus on those 15 or 20 items that they're cooking every day. Whereas in Indian restaurants, we have a menu which has 20 starters, 30 main courses, God knows what else. So at some place or the other, the quality suffers. So that's one thing that we need to actually try and incorporate in our industry, to reduce the amount of the menu items that we have.
So have you introduced this in your restaurant?
I've tried to. We've faced some backlash from our customers, but we've tried to cut down on, especially in our takeaway restaurant, we've tried to cut down on the menu as much as we can. We've kept it very, very lean. We've only got a few starters, few main courses, and we've hardly got any desserts on it. So yes, we've tried to incorporate this in our brands.
What are the challenges that you see in maintaining a restaurant right now as compared to what it was in the 4 years ago?
The biggest challenge now is the competition. With all these new aggregators coming in, there's a very big push and focus on discounting model, which is not very sustainable in the longer run, I personally believe. A person who's going to a platform like a Swiggy or a Uber Eats or a Zomato and ordering from a particular restaurant for the discount that they're getting on that day will probably not order from you the next time. So 4 years ago, it was not like that. If a person wanted to eat, he'll probably order from a brand that he loved, a restaurant whose food he loved, appreciated. Nowadays, the millennials especially, they're more focused on how cheap they can get the food, even whether they're going out, dining out, or whether they're ordering home delivery. So that's one of the biggest differences, I'd say, that we've seen what things were 4 years ago and now.
And how are you tackling these challenges?
So even if you get a customer through an online platform, you have to ensure that that customer becomes a loyal customer, and that can happen by delivering a quality product and by a great customer service. So both my brands, whenever we get an online order, whether it's through our own portal or through a third-party aggregator, we make sure that we give the person a follow-up call the next day, take their feedback. That way the customer also feels nice, and the next time when he's actually ordering food and not looking for a discount, he'll remember your brand, he'll remember the customer service. And obviously you have to keep the quality of your product high at all times, whether it's the quality of the food, the raw materials, the taste, the packing, the delivery experience, everything has to be top-notch.